Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So this is my very first video that I'm doing in my new house, like my first sit down video. So I apologize if it's a little echoey. We don't have very much furniture. We just got a couch, but that's about it. Also it's pouring rain outside, so if the lighting is cray, that is why. I have wanted to talk on this subject for pretty much the last year, ever since I popped out a baby. I am such a different person. And if you have watched my channel for the past few years, you guys will notice like, just like my decisions nowadays, what matters to me most, and just even like how I speak and the stuff that I say and the stuff that I value is just so different when I had a child. I've been so hesitant to make this video, and I've been wanting to make it for the past few months a lot because I feel like, I don't know, ever since I started meeting subscribers in person, I realized we have a lot more similarities in common than I thought. Throughout the past year, I've always felt like I've gone through this motherhood thing alone, even though I post everything online, as you guys know, and I talk to you guys a lot about like, you know, my whole pregnancy journey and just like struggles with being pregnant and having a newborn and breastfeeding and all the stuff that you're learning, I still felt very alone and I just felt like isolated as a mom, like a young new mom. So I don't know, I just wanted to talk in this video about like some struggles that I had gone through with motherhood, and the biggest thing being the adjustment of going from zero children and it's just you and your husband to one child. So how that affects your friendships, your marriage, even the relationship you have with yourself. It changes you so much as a woman and as a wife, as a new mom. So I wanted to go through all of those things and hopefully you guys can find some common ground with me. I again was always so hesitant about putting out this kind of video because I feel like anytime I ever talk about things being hard or challenging, or I'm stressed out, I'm not getting enough sleep, or I don't know, just like any kind of struggle, I get like a bombardment of comments saying that I'm either ungrateful, or I'm doing it wrong is the biggest one. I should be doing this instead of this. And I don't know, I'm just gonna try and ignore that as best I can, even though it affects, I mean, those kind of comments will affect any new mom especially, but I'm gonna try and ignore it because I know that there are moms like me out there that feel the exact same way as me because you guys DM me and you tell me. But I just wanted to document my struggles, and not even just my struggles, but like how I've come out the other side now that Annabelle is a year old. First thing I've noticed about myself as to why I've changed into such a different woman and just person in general. Before I had a child, I cared a lot about dumb shit. So I cared about vanity. I cared about relationships with friends that were very surface level. When you have a baby, you truly realize like what matters in life. Literally the only things that matter are your husband and your baby. And I'm not saying that your friends don't matter, or your parents or your relatives or your siblings or anything like that, but like your core group, like your little inner circle family, your new family, is the one thing that you think about constantly, and it's the one thing you want to protect and hold dear to you. And even your friends or your parents or just like people in your life, your family members, they might have a different idea as to like how you should be raising your child, or what you're doing as a mom. So I think like what really unites a family is that you're all thinking the same. So between you, your husband, and how you're raising your baby. So I don't know, you just realize like where your values are, that you know, shouldn't be spending so much money on vanity things. You'd rather spend money on your baby's future, or you should be cultivating time with your husband instead of that friend who you don't really care about, but that's kind of just like there in your life. It doesn't make you feel good about yourself. So yeah, that's like something that's been such a big eye-opener. I also feel like a lot of women and men, like anybody in their early 20s, especially, I don't know if it's this day and age or something, but everybody has like a timeline in their head of their life. They say, I want to get married by 25. I remember every girl in my sorority said that back when I was in college. You want to have a house by your 30, or by the time you're 30. You want a new car when you graduate. You want like all of these things that you have in your head, and if you don't meet the timeline, you feel like you're behind and you're not doing well, you're not successful. Well, I feel like, at least for Dung and I, when you have a baby, that all goes out the window because a lot of your money goes towards your baby and your baby's future and the stuff that they need to survive, obviously. So the timeline just kind of gets a little muddled, and I feel like I can take a breath in that way, like a nice deep, relaxing breath. Like, I don't feel like I have to meet anybody's expectations for my life. As long as me and my husband and my baby are happy and we're all just like happy together, I feel like it's fine. This is the biggest piece of advice I could give any pregnant mom. You need to cultivate mom friends. I know you're not gonna want to because you're big, you're pregnant, you don't feel cute, you don't want to go out of your comfort zone. But let me tell you, if you are pregnant and you're the first of your friends and you're surrounded by single friends like I was, or you're surrounded by people that don't have kids, you're gonna feel extremely alone. And that was my biggest hurdle for this last year. I know I put a lot of myself on the internet. I am very aware of that. I talk to you guys every single day. When I wake up, when I go to sleep, you know, I'm on my phone chatting to other moms, but it's just not the same thing at all. I can talk about mom stuff with other moms and baby stuff, but if you don't have like one-on-one connection with a mom, you're really gonna feel isolated. And I felt very isolated my first year of having Annabelle because I didn't know any mom friends. I had my sister, but she wasn't like next to me. Like, she wasn't there to help me breastfeed. She wasn't there to like, I don't know why I'm getting emotional, but wow, this is weird. I've never cried on a video. Oh wait, yes I have, when I was breastfeeding. Anyways, I didn't have a lot of people. I am totally not a crier YouTuber, like kill me now. But I didn't have a lot of moms that understood my situation. Whew. Like, okay, reel it back. I didn't have a lot of moms that understood my situation like right there. And you might think, oh, I'll be fine. Like, I have my mom, she birthed me. But let me tell you, your mom is probably 50 or 60 or 70 years old. Like, my mom is 62, I think, I don't know. She doesn't even know her age. But my mom is older and she hasn't had a baby in 25 years. Like, they don't remember how to breastfeed. Like, they, unless they're in the healthcare industry, and my mom is not in the baby healthcare. She's like an educational nurse, so she does not know. But unless they know how to breastfeed, like they're a lactation consultant or something, or they're a doctor, they're a baby doctor, there's a good chance that they don't remember like how to raise a tiny infant. So you don't have someone there to like hold your hands, like metaphorically, and just like walk you through the emotions. When I first had Annabelle, the first 2 weeks after she was born, I cried every single day, like a lot. Like, I was crying all the time. I thought I was going insane. Like, I for real thought something was wrong with me. I had no idea. It was called baby blues. Like, no one was there. My mom forgot like what that was. So my mom was concerned for me. It was just crazy. I didn't like have anyone to talk to about that. I didn't even know that was a real thing. But yeah, if I had had a mom friend to be like, Haley, chill, go ahead and cry because you need to cry. But this is called baby blues. And it's what happens when you have a baby, your hormones get out of whack. You cry about the, you know, randomest stuff. So I just wish I had someone there to like help me with that, like physically there. So anyways, I don't know why I got so emotional about that. Obviously that's a touchy subject, but that is my number one goal for moving to Charleston, is to meet mom friends that I can talk to stuff about. And it is nice to have your husband there. It's very helpful. Obviously they're so supportive, but they have no idea. Like, they don't have boobs. Like, they don't know how to breastfeed. They don't have the hormones that we have in our bodies. So you just, anyways, bottom line, you need to get some mom friends. Join a group, go to meetup.com. You have to do it for your sanity. The second thing and the biggest thing that I have noticed in a lot of moms in like my private Facebook group for my YouTube channel, which if you're not a part of, you should definitely join, because these women are amazing. I mean, I'm rarely involved on there because they post so much, like I can't keep up. I'll link it down below if you guys wanna join. You have to be like approved to make sure you're not a spammer. But anyways, that group is amazing. Like, they're so supportive. Somebody could post like the most outlandish stuff, which they definitely do, and nobody judges them. Like, it's nothing like YouTube. I love it so much. And it's mostly moms, but also like single girls too. Anyways, so a lot of topics in there kind of revolve around like becoming a new mom and the friendships that suffer. So the one thing I've noticed since becoming a mom is that the girls in your life, like the friends in your life that don't have children yet, I do feel like the relationships are strained. Not all of my relationships. So I could definitely say there are three friends in my life right now that nothing has changed since I've had a baby. Like, they are with me, you know, through and through. They are my rocks. Like, I could cry on them when I'm breastfeeding and they don't even know how to breastfeed themselves. So that is so rare. But a lot of my friendships have been strained. I'm actually not friends with one girl that I was friends with because she didn't, I don't know. There's a big story there I'm not gonna get into. But when you have a baby, a lot of your friends, a lot of the, I guess, surface level friends, they're not gonna wanna understand your situation. If you can't go to certain events, or if you can't go to their party, if you're late to something that they need you to be at because your baby's crying and you know, your baby has colic, or your baby, you know, wants to be fed, you can't breastfeed them, they're dropping weight and it's stressful, you wanna keep your baby alive. So those friends, a lot of them are not gonna want to sympathize with you. They just kinda think, well, I don't know, they just think about themselves, honestly. So a lot of your friendships will be strained, not a lot, but I would say like the surface level friendships. And having a baby really helps weed out like who your actual friends are. It's been really eye-opening, it's been really sad. I've cried a lot about it throughout the past year. I mean, I've cried a lot this past year in general, but that is one thing that I feel like nobody talks about in the motherhood group, as far as like what can happen to your relationships. It's the same as family members. I mean, there are family members, not necessarily in my life, but I see a lot of you guys on my Facebook group saying that like, you know, there are a lot of family members that don't agree with how you parent at all. They don't even think you should breastfeed. And if you're breastfeeding every 2 hours, that's gonna put a strain on your relationship if someone thinks very strongly about that. So you just gotta prepare yourself to like stay in your lane, stay focused, and do what you feel is right. And if they kind of fall by the wayside, that is just how it's gonna be. The other thing that is really big that I've noticed, and I kind of like just clicked with me the other day, and Doug actually, you kind of start to realize that like if there are people in your life that don't care about your baby, you're just like inevitably not gonna care about them. I know that sounds so harsh, but I have a few people in my life that could care less about my baby. Like they don't ask about her, they don't wanna know anything really about her, like what she's doing. Even though I post my stuff online, like not everybody watches it, and I don't blame them. Like they definitely shouldn't if they're in my life because they already know me, but they don't keep up with her and they don't ever ask. I don't know, they just have no interest in her. So it just makes me less interested in them as people, because you guys know if you have babies, your baby is like your freaking pride and joy. Like you don't care about yourself at all once you have a baby. All you want is attention to be on your baby because you just love it so much. And when there are people in your life that don't want anything to do with your baby and just kind of like, I don't know, they just don't care. There's just a little bit of a disconnect then between that relationship. And yeah, it just kind of suffers. At least it has for me. Let me know in the comments. So that is another thing I've noticed. I also want to say another thing about friendships. I know this is like a huge topic and this video is going to be an hour long, but whatever, it's going to be long. So another thing I've noticed, and something that has really resonated with me, I just read a book recently and like one of the quotes in it was, you are the average of the 5 closest people in your life. So if you think about it, write a list. I literally did this with Doug. Like, who are the 5 closest people in your life? You're those people. So if you're raising a child for the first time and you want them to be just like superhuman, like you want them to be good at school and smart and independent and not relying on anybody else and loving and compassionate and all of these things that make up a really good human, you have to surround them by people that have those things. It's just made me realize like why I have the people in my life that I do and who I probably shouldn't hang around with as much. Just because like of my baby. So anyways, that is that about friendships. The other thing that I've noticed that has changed like me as a person is I'm a hot mess. I mean, you put yourself last on the totem pole when you have a baby. And when I say last, I mean like an insect. Like you literally don't get anything done for yourself. I know a lot of moms are gonna be like, oh, Haley, this is just you. I don't believe any of you. Like I know that it's not just me in this department, even though moms like to tell me and mom shame me about that. I know it's not just me because a lot of you guys snap me your house. It looks like a freaking tornado went off. You know, you haven't plucked your eyebrows in 2 months. You haven't gotten a manicure since your baby was born and your baby's like 15 months old. I don't know. Maybe those are extremes, but I feel like I legit put myself like so last. And one of my goals for 2018 is to make time for myself, because it's so funny that I have to say that, because before I had a baby, it was like me all the time. And now I have to like actually schedule time like in my calendar phone to like get like paint my nails and have Doug watch the baby. So it's just hilarious like how I'm such a hot mess. Taking long showers, no way. I mean, I hear like a whining baby outside my door. I try and use the restroom. She climbs up my lap. I know that's disgusting, but I know it's not just me. What else? Blow dry my hair. I mean, I have to wake up at 5:30 to get ready. Because if I wake up at 7, she's like half awake and I'll like wake her up and it's just a nightmare. So I have to wake up early. I go to sleep so late to edit my videos and do my job. I go to sleep at like 12 or 1. I mean, I barely get any sleep. So I truly feel like I'm definitely a hot mess these days. And that's just how it is, but whatever. It's like a fun, crazy, psychotic time, but I wouldn't change it for the world. So the other thing that I have noticed since becoming a mom is stress and anxiety is a whole nother level. I just told Doug yesterday, and Annabelle is 13 months old, that I feel like today is the first day for the last 13 months where I have a handle on my shit. And I know that sounds dramatic, but I feel like I can do this parenting thing. It's taken me a year to like tell myself, Haley, calm down. Like, don't be so anxiety ridden. Like, don't be so stress ridden when the baby cries or when she like needs breastfeeding or whatever. I feel like I'm just now getting over that hump and it's taken me so long. So if you feel like you're stressed out all the time, either because you don't want to give your baby formula, or because you don't want to breastfeed your baby, or because you don't, you know, your baby won't eat anything and it won't like, it doesn't like any food, or because, you know, you want to sleep train your baby, or you want to co-sleep your baby, like whatever it is, anxiety comes with all of that. I know it's like that for so many moms. It was like that for me. I took it to another level because I don't know why. I just haven't been around any babies ever, hardly. And I think because of that, I didn't even know where to start. Like I never even saw an example for it because my sister doesn't even live in my state. So yeah, anxiety is like so real when you're a mom, especially if you've never experienced baby life or even seen it. So I have no tips for that other than I finally got out of it. So at least there's a light at the end of the tunnel. With that being said, another thing that has changed my world so much that you guys are talking about a ton in the Facebook group, is your marriage might suffer when you have a baby. I don't want to scare you because, you know, babies are the best thing ever. It's going to bless your marriage and your life for the rest of your life. But something to be, just like aware of. You have to actually be aware of this, I feel, because if you don't, it can get out of hand. So when you have a baby, there's sleepless nights, you're very irritable, you know, your marriage is the last thing you think about. Date nights, I mean, what are those for the first 6 months, if you're breastfeeding especially? And yeah, just like, I feel like Doug and I's relationship has just now gotten back on track and it's been so long. I know like it's not like this for other moms. And I also know that it's like this for a ton of moms. So let me know in the comments what you guys think. But Doug and I have had to schedule like date nights in because we never leave our baby. So nights where we don't work when she goes to sleep on our business, nights where we literally just sit. I mean, we just now started watching Netflix again together, which is like crazy. We haven't watched it in, I think, like 8 months or something crazy. So, cause we've been working on our business. So we've had to schedule times that when she goes to sleep, we put the monitor on, we co-sleep. So we put pillows all around her, make sure she doesn't roll off. I'm staring at the monitor anyways. And we just veg out together and like cuddle and hold hands and have quality time. Because if you don't put your marriage first, like everything in your life will fall apart. No longer just you and your husband, it's you, your husband and your baby. And I promise you guys, if you're in the thick of it right now and it's very stressful on a day-to-day basis with your new baby, if you're a first-time mom, it gets so much better. Like when the baby starts to just be less fragile, I guess, and when you have a routine down, like when you know your nap schedule and when they're not waking all the time, your marriage, I promise, will go back to how it was. I mean, it's different, but it will still go back to like the, I guess just like having the ability to have quality time together. So yeah, that is definitely something that has changed. The next thing that is such a big lesson I've learned with motherhood is you force yourself to take it slow. Like I literally have no patience. I think it's like a Portuguese thing. I don't even know. My whole family is high strung and they have no patience at all. So when you have a baby, you have to force yourself, especially if you practice attachment parenting like I do and co-sleeping and breastfeeding, you have to have patience because the baby, it takes so long to learn anything and like to get anything down when the baby's not latching right or when you feel like you don't have enough milk. I get that email all the time. You don't know if you should co-sleep, you feel guilty, you don't have time for yourself, or your baby is just like crying all the time, you don't know why. You have to practice patience. It's taken me so long, but now when something is frustrating, instead of like getting super aggressive about it like I usually am, I legit like sit there and take a deep breath. I know it sounds so crazy, but I think to myself, this is gonna pass. Like, the years are so short. This year has gone by so fast, and it's been the most stressful slash happiest year of my life, if that makes any sense. The years go by so fast, but the days are so long and they can be very exhausting and stressful. So just like take a deep breath and know that it's gonna pass. And although this time in your life can be stressful, you can have anxiety about a lot of things when it comes to raising your child and your marriage and your friendships and you're managing all these things as a wife and mom. It can be a lot, I totally get it. But it's gonna pass, and you just have to focus on the fact that your baby's so tiny and so cute, and they'll never do the things that they're doing right now at this moment again. So doing that has really helped me just like have more patience and the ability to like let things go. Motherly instincts are so strong and real. I have heard about mom instincts ever since I had Annabelle. I thought it was just a fluke. Like, I legit thought that's just something someone said, like, oh, haha, I have such a good mom instinct because I knew my daughter was getting a cookie in the kitchen. And I didn't hear her, but I just like knew. I don't know. I always thought it was just kind of something that mom said as a funny joke, but it's so real. And I did not listen to my mom instincts for like the first three or five months of when Annabelle was born. If I had listened to my motherly instincts, my whole life would have been so much better for the last year. I would have been less stressed out about like different things, sleeping arrangements and breastfeeding, all that stuff. I would have just listened to my intuition and just listened to my inner mom voice, if that makes any sense. I protested co-sleeping for so long because I thought it was wrong and I thought it was dangerous and I just thought she'd never get out of our bed. And now it's just totally right for our family. Like, I should have just been like, this is right for us. Like, I don't care what anybody else does in America, you know. I want to co-sleep because it feels right. Like, it's my mom intuition. Even Doug has one too. Like, dads have it too. So if I had just listened to that, I wouldn't have had to have those months of, you know, pondering and switching things and changing things. I would have just given in to what feels right. Motherhood gives you the utmost respect for other moms. Before I had a baby, we used to go to restaurants, there'd be like screaming kids. Even my sister's, you know, she has three kids now, but at the time she had two kids, they were crazy, bouncing off the walls. They were like two under two, it's just insane. And that's what she had. And I looked at that and was like, what the heck? Like, I don't understand it. I don't wanna understand it. The kids look like they're so wild. Well, nowadays when there are kids at restaurants and they're screaming, I look at that mom and I say, you are super mom for even getting out of the house with those crazy banshee kids. And not in a bad way, but in like a props to you for like doing something that you wanna do, even with your two kids. So it just gives me such an utmost respect for other moms, especially moms with multiple, since I only have one. I had a meetup I think 2 months ago, and a mom of twins came to the meetup. Like, she brought her twins and they were small, like smaller than Annabelle. And I'm just like, you literally drove at, I don't even know how long, pretty far away with your two twins to come meet me, and you came with twins. Like, I was just mind blown. I still think about that on days when it's hard as a stay-at-home mom and you're just losing your marbles. I think, like, you know, if that mom can literally come to my meetup with twins, I can do anything. Like, I can't complain. So I just have so much more respect for other moms, moms of younger kids, of older kids. It just makes you have such an appreciation for like mom life, I guess. So yeah, that is pretty much it for the longest video probably on my channel that I've ever made. That's what I wanted to share with you guys, and it's been a hard but very rewarding year. If you guys like this video and you're still here, press the like button, subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye guys.